China is watching the war in Ukraine closely. It has plans, big plans, and they hinge on the war coming to a quick end without a clear Ukrainian victory. For China, Russia doesn't have to win, but it can't suffer a total defeat either. A key component of their plan hinges on what happens next in Ukraine. Since the beginning of the war, China has been somewhat standoffish about its position and how far it's willing to go to support Russia. Chinese leadership backs Russia not because they're best friends or share the same ideology, but because China can't let the West, especially the United States, extend its influence any further than it already has. This is why China has been calling for negotiations and a ceasefire to end the conflict in Ukraine. However, they also hold the stipulation that Russia should be able to maintain control of certain territories that it invaded, even if they were seized illegally. What game is China playing? Why have they suddenly become more vocal about an agreement being reached to end the war? It probably comes as little surprise that China has a sinister reason for wanting peace between Russia and Ukraine, and it's not what you might think. Let's start by understanding China's stance on the war and how it sees Russia as a cog in its greater plans for dominance. China believes that the blame for what's happening in Ukraine belongs to multiple parties. The first is Russia, who, although China still supports, is not completely happy with. There's no denying that Russia was the aggressor in the conflict, and China has even said as much. However, they also place just as much blame on the West, and in particular the United States, for what's happening in Ukraine. This is because China claims the West has consistently ignored Russia's security concerns. The threat to Russia's way of life due to the encroachment of NATO and Western powers closer to their borders is the reason that Russia had to invade Ukraine. At least this is what China stated. They stand behind the notion that the security of every country should be considered by taking into account the interests and concerns of all parties involved. China stands by the belief that the West dominating Eastern Europe and spreading its influence closer and closer to Russia led to the inevitable invasion of Ukraine. Putin's hands were tied because he needed to protect Russian interests, and since the West wouldn't listen to his concerns, the only thing he could do was invade Ukraine. Again, this is what China says happened, but take it with a grain of salt because, of course, there is much more going on. Although there might be some truth to what China is claiming, NATO trying to weaken Russia and spread Western influence throughout Europe is not exactly what was happening. Even so, it's hard to argue that a power-hungry tyrant such as Vladimir Putin had the Russian people's best interest at heart when he invaded Ukraine. Now, China has laid out some key tenets that will drive its global policies and decisions in the coming years. A lot of what China wants hinges on the war coming to a swift end without Russia suffering a total defeat. At this point, all indications point to an eventual Ukrainian victory. It's only a matter of time before NATO tanks, modern weapons, and further aid reach the Ukrainian military. China knows this, which is why they're pushing for negotiations now. Russia losing the war by force and being completely pushed out of Ukraine would be very bad for China. Therefore, the peace talks they're hoping for will end with Russia maintaining some kind of control in parts of Ukraine. We know that this is not an option for President Volodymyr Zelensky. For him and the rest of Ukraine's citizens, there are only two options. Either Russian forces leave willingly, or they should be prepared to fight until the last soldier dies on the battlefield. Ukraine will not allow Russia to control any of its territory, including Crimea, any longer. And the truth is, they don't have to. Ukraine will almost certainly win the war with the help of Western powers. This is why China is scrambling to broker some kind of deal, where Russia isn't faced with total defeat. Fu Kong, the Chinese ambassador to the EU, recently voiced his country's concerns over what a complete victory in Ukraine would mean for the geopolitical state of the world. His statements were carefully worded, but it was clear that there were underlying threats in what the ambassador was saying, especially when he brought up another part of the world that China has had its sights on for some time now. Before we get to these threats, let's dive deeper into why exactly China doesn't want Ukraine to win the war. It actually has very little to do with their ties to Russia or any interest they have in the region itself. Instead, there is a much broader net China wishes to cast, and it can only do so if Ukraine doesn't claim complete victory. In his speech to the European Policy Center, Fu Xiong said, "Frankly speaking, we are quite concerned about the possible escalation of this conflict. This may indicate that China doesn't want to see Russia rolling out its nuclear arsenal in a last-ditch effort to win the war. Since China has much closer ties to Putin than the West does, they may know something we don't. But it's more likely that China's just using the threat of escalation as a scare tactic to try to bring Ukraine to the negotiating table with an open mind." It's also no coincidence that Fu Xiong's speech occurred at the same time that President Zelensky was set to visit London on his first trip to Western Europe since the war started. China likes to time its statements, military drills, and political decisions to coincide with events they do not agree with. It's their passive-aggressive way of voicing their displeasure without instigating full-fledged conflicts. Fuchong also reiterated President Xi Jinping's sentiments that when looking at the current crisis and any such event that might arise in the future, global power should take the security concerns of both sides into consideration, not just those that are closely allied with the West. China suggests that this may reduce the risk of conflict down the road. Maybe they're right, but the fact that China also has its own agenda means that their advice also needs to be taken with a grain of salt. And this is where the crux of the situation lies. China does not want to see Ukraine win the conflict because it's currently engaged in a delicate balancing act. China has closely allied itself with Russia, less because the leaders of each country see eye to eye, and more because China needs help combating the economic, military, and political dominance the United States and European nations have around the world. Russia has acted like a buffer between China and the West, both literally and metaphorically. Russia's powerful military, economy, and influence, at least on paper, kept the West in check and made sure they didn't overextend in the parts of the world that might cause international conflict. This included much of Asia, which allowed China some freedom to increase its own power and influence in the region, because the United States and its allies couldn't be everywhere at once. It also didn't hurt that the combined strength of Russia and China was a formidable power to contend with, and if none of those deterrents worked, Russia was more than willing to threaten to blow up the world with nukes, which seemed to keep the West from pushing their luck. China's concerned that if Ukraine wins the war and completely defeats Russia, Moscow will need to make concessions. In a worst-case scenario, this could lead to the installation of a regime that's much more lenient toward the West's expanding influence. Or, in China's biggest nightmare, the Russian Federation could collapse into a civil war, and the outcome could be a democratic republic arising that becomes part of the very ideology that China opposes. The real reason that China wants a ceasefire and peace talks to be initiated between Russia and Ukraine is out of fear. China is afraid of the West becoming more powerful. They're afraid that a Russian defeat could lead to Western influence spreading closer to their borders. And they're afraid that everything they've worked so hard to achieve and becoming a dominant player on the world stage will be lost. The fear is real for China. Russia will likely not be the only nation that loses power and influence if Ukraine wins the war. All of their allies, including China, will need to rethink how they conduct themselves on the world stage. Ukraine is proving that Russia was not nearly as strong and powerful as everyone believed. With this illusion broken, China is incredibly scared that the West could be emboldened to dominate Asia by spreading its ideology across the continent. So the best-case scenario right now is for China to advocate for a ceasefire to help Russia save face. They also want the war to end in a way that will hopefully keep Putin in power, or at least see him replaced by a regime that's still staunchly against the spread of Western influence. However, China has decided it won't throw its full official support behind Russia. Its government has remained relatively silent about the war up to now because it doesn't want to suffer similar sanctions from the West as Russia is. The main goal is to keep China's influence and economy growing, which is not contingent on Russia's success. However, it is contingent on Western powers being kept in check, especially in Asia. In fact, China knows its future actually lies in its ability to sell technology, goods, and labor to the West. China's economy will continue to grow only if it maintains some kind of partnership between themselves, Europe, and the United States. But if Russia falls, it could lead to the West asking for too many concessions from China in the future. It's also likely that China never saw Russia as a major player in their plans to grow. It was nice to have Russia as a buffer and for extra security when things became dicey in parts of Central Asia, such as Afghanistan or Syria. However, in terms of growing China's economy and spreading its influence, Russia had very little purpose. That being said, China's Belt and Road Initiative to connect their nation to Europe via a network of roads and railways has come under threat. This is a minor setback, as the completion of this transportation network isn't contingent on Russia winning the war. However, progress has slowed, as men and resources are sent to the front lines to aid in the war effort. If China can manage to initiate peace talks, it'll still lead to a further weakening of Russia. However, that might be okay, because a weakened Russia is a Russia that will be even more reliant on China. This will only strengthen the growth of their economy. But until they can get Russia out of the war, China's plans to extend its influence and trade network to European markets will continue to stall. But even a weakened Russia is better than no Russia at all. Again, it all comes back to the buffer between China and the West. As long as Russia can maintain its autonomy and still has the threat of launching nuclear warheads at its enemies, NATO will probably only push its luck so far when it comes to establishing military bases and conducting operations in Asia. A total defeat of Russia in Ukraine could jeopardize the status quo, which would cause serious security concerns for the Chinese government. It is interesting to note that China doesn't necessarily want to dominate the world. What it's really seeking is a multipolar order. What this means is that China wants to be the United States' equal, not a nation that it's trying to play catch-up to. The US is the only superpower in the world. China wants to join this exclusive club to spread its own ideologies and influence. Obviously, the US doesn't want a multipolar system, as it would then no longer be able to influence geopolitics unimpeded. However, not everyone in the world agrees with the Western way of life. There are plenty of countries that probably wish there was someone to challenge the United States so it would stop building military bases wherever it wanted, while also exploiting other nations' resources, but this is a discussion for another time. What is important is that China wants to be able to compete with the US's economic and political power. Would President Xi Jinping like to rule the world? Probably. However, as of right now, China's goal is to create a multipolar system where it's able to compete with the United States by becoming the world's second superpower. If Russia collapses due to a total defeat in Ukraine, this goal could be put in serious jeopardy. Everything discussed thus far has to do with China's fear that a Russian defeat in the war will lead to the spread of Western ideology further into Asia. But at the beginning of this video, we mentioned there was something more sinister going on. Buckle in, because during his statement declaring China's desire to see a ceasefire, Fu Kong also made it clear that something more alarming was brewing near China's borders. Fu Kong warned senior officials from the EU and other Western powers that they should stop sending delegations to Taiwan. China continuously claims that the island of Taiwan is part of its territory, even though most of the world, including Taiwan itself, identifies the island as a sovereign nation called the Republic of China. Fu Kong was also adamant that there could be no comparison between what Russia was doing to Ukraine and China's actions toward Taiwan. He said, "I must state up front that the Ukrainian crisis and the Taiwan issue are two completely different things. Ukraine is an independent state, and Taiwan is part of China, so there's no comparability between the two issues. And yet, they are very much the same. Russia claimed that Ukraine was rightfully part of their territory, so they invaded. China claims that Taiwan is rightfully part of its territory, so if they invade, it would almost be the exact same series of events that have been unfolding between Russia and Ukraine over the past year. Even if Fu Kong and the rest of the Chinese leadership deny all similarities, they must know deep down that if they took military action against Taiwan, the response from the West would not just be similar, but more extreme than what has been happening to Russia. Perhaps China's been taking detailed notes on what the West is willing to do and how far they're willing to go to stop a rival power from claiming territory. China has seen that the US and NATO will send monetary and military aid to Taiwan. China has watched as sanctions imposed by the West have slowly begun to cripple the Russian economy. And as Russia is pushed further and further out of Ukrainian territory, China is watching the repercussions that the invasion will have on Russia's influence in the world. Maybe China advocating for a ceasefire is just a ploy to see if there will be any leniency given to Russia for their actions. China must know that if they invade Taiwan, it will lead to war. And if the United States steps in, it'll be a war that China cannot win. There's little doubt that China wants the world to acknowledge their rule over Taiwan, but unless they take it by force, this will likely never happen. This is why Fu Kong left European leaders with a warning. If the European Union engages in investment treaties with Taiwan, it would fundamentally change or shake the foundation of the relationship between the EU and China. Whether this is an empty threat or if China will take drastic actions to keep Western powers from becoming closer to Taiwan is unclear. However, the fact is that this is all being discussed while China is calling for a ceasefire between Ukraine and Russia is a telling sign. China is in a tough spot. Its strongest ally is about to be defeated in a war that it started. Its biggest enemies are only becoming bolder because of what's happening in Ukraine. China's ambitions to become a superpower are slowly slipping away the closer Ukraine comes to winning. However, it's not all doom and gloom. China has benefited from this war. As sanctions were imposed on Russia, it drove the country right into China's arms. Anything Russia needed, they had to get from their allies, and China was more than happy to sell them the goods. This gave China an economic boost at a time it desperately needed it. The war also allowed China to watch the West's reaction to an invasion, which provided valuable data to the future if they ever decided to seize land from one of their neighbors. China saw how slow NATO was to provide the necessary weapons and equipment Ukraine required, but eventually they did come. This information may be used in any future plans that China makes for securing Taiwan or expanding its borders in other ways. China also now knows what kind of sanctions and the limits to which the West is willing to go to punish a nation for invading another. And while the world is focused on Ukraine, China has been sneakily expanding its influence in Oceania and South Asia. The United States and the EU have sent so much aid and supplies to Ukraine that they don't have the resources to keep China in check in East Asia and the Pacific. bloody conflicts have broken out along the Himalayan border between Chinese Tibet and India, the Chinese Navy is commissioning new ships, and new trade relations are being forged between China and the countries around them. If China was using the war in Ukraine to gather intelligence, plan for the future, and strengthen its position in Asia, it has succeeded. Now, China is trying to persuade Russia and Ukraine to stop fighting so the new status quo can develop. If things go too far and Ukraine completely defeats Russia, it will jeopardize China's future plans. The past has been a balancing act between strengthening their ties with other non-Western nations to increase their influence close to home and keeping a buffer between themselves and Western nations. China's biggest fear if Ukraine wins the war is that Russia will either collapse or a pro-Western regime will replace Putin. Both of these things would allow the United States and the EU to expand their influence into Asia and threaten everything China has been working so hard to achieve. For those of us who live in the West, this is not something we worry about, but Russia losing the war could threaten the power that the leaders in China now hold. This is why China wants peace in Ukraine. It's afraid that if Russia loses, they will too. Now watch why China will never be a global superpower, or check out how the US will respond if China invades Taiwan.